Namaskar and welcome to this brand new episode of Yuva, which is a cutting-edge initiative to bring the youth of India and the thoughts of Swami Vivekananda on the same platform. Swami Vivekananda once said, "Stand up, be bold, be strong, take the entire responsibility on your shoulder, and be the creator of your own destiny." Taking these lines seriously, a group of youngsters are doing just that in Bengaluru.
Swami Vivekananda at many places said, "My hope lies on the youth." And whenever he laid down any plan for development of the country, he said the youth must shoulder, they must take the responsibility. And wanted to do something for the country, something for my people, then I thought, why not do something with the youth? And then I also sensed that in the today's generation of college students and young professionals, there is a great degree of responsibility and the urge to do something. They want to make a difference, but they did not know where to start. Not through lectures, you know, writings that we wanted youth to connect, but youth must volunteer, get connected with the people, then they themselves will feel the need. And again, Swami Vivekananda stressed in many places that education is the mantra. If India has to progress, everyone must be educated. If children are not coming to school, schools must go to where children are. This is what struck me when Lata Rao came to me and said, "See, there are a lot of children in our neighborhood who are not going to school."
Like, we were constructing a new house in this upcoming layout. So I used to see all these children roaming around in the sun doing nothing. So I thought I should do something for these children. So I started visiting this construction workers' children. So they just live in a temporary shed, which is constructed beside the construction site. I used to go to their houses personally and talk to their parents and ask them why they are not sending their children to the school. What their problem is, like, they are new to the place, they don't know where to go, and they have to take care of the younger ones. So I thought, why don't you send them to my school, which is nearby? They can just come by, walk. So I started convincing them. Still, they were very reluctant. Like, many of the volunteers from YFS, they helped me out, because it's very difficult to manage alone the entire show. In case of emergency, there are many children with different levels of intelligence. Each child we have to give separate attention. So usually my friends and some of the housewives in our area, weekly once or twice they come here. They do different kinds of activities, teach songs, drawing, all this.
And so when we looked at children in slums and even in government schools, because most of the children in government schools, they come from slums. And even though government has many schemes to address the health problems, because the parents are ignorant, they don't take the children to the hospitals. See, the government provides free treatment for children going to schools, but someone has to take them to the hospital. That was a big gap. And this is where Youth for Seva started this program, where volunteers conduct the health camps in schools. And we involve in a team of doctors called Doctors for Seva. And after the checkup is done, anyone who needs treatment, our volunteers take them to the hospital. Swamiji always emphasized on that. And he told the young people that you'll be closer to God by playing football rather than studying Gita. And that's the kind of emphasis he laid on the health of children, especially the youth. What we have seen in the past 4 years is a tremendous response from the youth. Without any advertisement publicity, YFS has attracted over 4,500 volunteers in Bangalore. So this only goes to show the kind of potential that exists and the intent that already is there amongst the youth, that they want to do something positive. And Swamiji again and again said, "They alone live who live for others. Rest are more dead than alive." And that message strikes so much chords with the youth. that they can resonate with this idea, and they all see the joy in giving. When you go out and work with people, feel connected with others, there is a tremendous amount of joy that people experience. The youth are coming in large numbers because the trend is to volunteer today. It's fashionable. And what is needed is the infrastructure. In fact, all that Youth for Seva has provided is the infrastructure to volunteer. So whatever time commitment you have, whether you have few hours in the weekends or on the weekdays, whatever is the amount of time commitment you have, we will show you what all you can do.
Inspiring, isn't it? And why should it not be? We've already begun celebrating the 150th birth anniversary of Swami Vivekanand, which comes in 2013. And there are people who are walking his path. There are people who are making effective changes in society. And that seems to be the hope for the youth of today, where everybody is looking for a direction in life. We aspire to bring such inspirational stories and inspiring people to you through Yuva. So keep watching our episodes. Thank you.